Hello students, secondary chemistry, second one. Now we are still in unit 4, thermochemistry. Now we are going to study a new method for calculation of delta H. In this time, we determine delta H in terms of the bond energies. During chemical reaction, in the reactants, bonds are broken, and in the products, bonds are formed. If you want to break a bond, you must exert energy. But if a bond is formed, energy is given out or is given off. So the bond energy is known to be the energy required to break the bond, or the energy released when a bond is formed in one mole of the substance. For example, here are the reactants. This is a molecular reaction of a reactant. Bond is needed to break the bonds between atoms. After breaking, atoms becomes free. So this part is endothermic because this part requires energy. So breaking of bonds is an endothermic process which requires energy. In the products, new bonds are formed, and after forming the bonds, energy is given out of this bond formation process. This is exothermic part. So the total reaction contains two parts. First part is breaking of bonds, which require energy, and the second part is formation of bonds, which is an exothermic part. So breaking of chemical bonds requires energy, and this is called endothermic part. Forming of new bonds in the products releases energy or gives out energy. This part is exothermic part. When we compare between an exothermic and endothermic reaction, we compare between them in different respects. The important one here is in bonding. In the exothermic reaction, bond forming energy is greater than bond breaking energy. But in endothermic reaction, bond breaking energy is greater than bond making energy. From the graph, these are the reactants and these are the products. When reactants absorb energy to break the bonds, energy increases by this part. This part represents bond breaking energy, which is an endothermic part. Then when the bonds are formed, the energy is decreasing. So bond making is accompanied by liberation or giving out or release of energy. So the energy decreases, and this reaction represents an exothermic reaction as a whole, because the bond breaking energy is less, small, is a small part, but bond release energy is high. So this reaction is exothermic reaction. If you want to calculate delta H for the whole reaction, we add the bond energy needed to break the bonds, then subtract the sum of the energy released during the chemical formation, the formation of bonds. For example, if you want to calculate delta H for H2 plus Cl2 gives 2HCl. These numbers represent the bond energy, the energy required to break the bonds, or the energy released when bonds are formed. To answer this question, we draw H2 as HH to show the bond which will be broken. Cl2, Cl, Cl. 2HCl, HCl, and HCl, two times. Okay? This bond is broken and needs energy. The bond energy of the HH is 432. So we need 432 kilojoule per mole to break this bond. In the same way, the Cl-Cl bond is broken and requires 240 kilojoules of per mole of energy. And after breaking these bonds, new bonds are formed between hydrogen and chlorine. The bond formation is accompanied by release or giving out of energy. The bond energy for HCl is 430. This energy will be liberated by one mole of bonds. Here are two moles of bonds. One bond and two bonds means two moles of bonds. So we multiply 430 by 2 to get all the energy liberated by the formation of two moles of HCl bonds. So we calculated H as follows. Summation of the heat of the energy required to break the bonds, this bond and this bond. So we add this bond and this bond, 432 plus 240. This is the summation of the energy required to break the bonds in the reactants, minus sum of the bond energy liberated by the formation of bonds, 2 by 130. This is the way we can calculate delta H in kilojoules. Another example is the decomposition of water into hydrogen and oxygen. If you want to calculate delta H for this reaction in terms of the bond energies of the HH and OO and OH energy bonds, let's draw the reactants and products to show the bond that will be broken and the bond that will be formed. In the reactants, bonds are broken. 2H2 means OHH, this is one molecule of water or one mole of water, and 2H2 means that HOH and HOH. Here 2H2 means H2 and H2, we draw them in this way to show the broken bonds. And O2 means OO. OO, here is double bond because each oxygen atom is a divalent atom that can form two covalent bonds. But hydrogen is a monovalent atom, so it forms only one single bond, single covalent bond. Okay, here in the reactants, 4HO, HO, HO, HO bonds are broken, four bonds. And this requires 4 by 464 kilojoule. Okay, so the answer here is 4 by 464. This is the bonds broken here, minus the sum of the energy liberated during formation of bonds. Here this bond is formed and this bond is formed, this bond is formed. So we multiply 2 by the HH energy of the bond, which is 2 by 436. Here is 2 by 436 plus only one bond here, so 499 plus 499 here, then calculate delta H in this way and put the unit kilojoule per mole. This is how to calculate delta H in terms of the bond energy. Here is another method for calculation of delta H in terms of the number of moles in without an equation. To calculate delta H, this is delta H in the upper part of the triangle. This is the delta H, which is the quantity of heat lost or gained in a chemical reaction in kilojoule. This may be also denoted by QP, which is the quantity of heat at constant pressure, which is the condition of experiment. N is the number of moles, and delta H naught is the heat, the standard heat content change, or the molar heat content change. The unit here is kilojoule per mole. So if you want to calculate delta H naught, divide delta H in kilojoule or QP in kilojoule over N, which is the number of moles in moles. This is an example. If half mole of a substance released by a combustion of 450 kilojoule, then calculate delta C naught combustion. C means combustion for this substance. This is delta H or K, and this is the number of moles N. So if you want to calculate here delta H naught, divide this over this, means that 400 over half. 400 over half gives 900 kilojoule per mole. The answer seems to be this, but in fact this is the heat released. So the change here in delta H is negative, because this is an exothermic reaction which releases heat. So this is the answer. Okay. This is another problem. When reacting 0.236 mole of a weak base with an excess of HCl, which is called the neutralization reaction, a quantity of energy 9.91 kilojoule is released. The amount of energy is kilojoule. This is delta H, or this is QP. Divide QP over the number of moles here, which is N. Divide these two numbers, so get delta H naught in the same way. Okay, and this, in this way you can calculate delta H naught. Here, if 9.8 grams of sulfuric acid released 300 kilojoule, the 300 kilojoule, this is delta H in kilojoule, or this is QP. To calculate delta H, which is required, the target of this problem is to calculate delta H, naught, divide Q over N. Where is N? N here, number of moles, is not given in this problem. It is required first to calculate the number of moles. How to calculate the number of moles? Divide the mass in gram over the molar mass of sulfuric acid. You have studied in the first term how to calculate the molar mass of any substance from the formula and from the atomic masses. Calculate the atomic, the molecular mass of sulfuric acid, or the molar mass of sulfuric acid. H2SO4 means 2 by 1 plus 32 plus 4 by 16. This gives 98. So divide the mass in gram over the molar mass, which is 98 for sulfuric acid, to get 0.1 mole of sulfuric acid. This is the number of moles. Then divide 300, which is delta H or QP, over 0.1, which is the number of moles, to get the standard heat content change. This is another example which is similar to the last example. If the standard change in the heat content for delta H naught for sodium hydroxide is minus 200 kilojoule per mole, This is delta H naught. So this is delta H naught. And the number of moles for sodium hydroxide can be calculated by dividing the mass in gram. This one is the mass in gram over the molar mass of sodium hydroxide. Calculate first the molar mass of sodium hydroxide, 23 plus 16 plus 1, which is 40, divide 300 over 40, the molar mass of sodium hydroxide, to get 0.75 mole. This is the number of mole. Then divide, then multiply. Multiply the number of moles by delta H naught. This is delta H naught, to get the delta H, the quantity of heat lost. This is how to calculate it. Now, how to calculate delta H in terms of the equation, number of moles from the equation. This is the same law, but here the number of moles can be obtained from the equation itself. Okay, calculate the standard heat of formation of ammonia. To calculate the standard heat of formation of ammonia gas from this reaction, this is delta H in kilojoule. This is the numerator, delta H kilojoule. This is kilojoule. What about the number of moles? For ammonia, the number of moles is 2. This is the number of moles, N. This is 2. So N here is 2 for ammonia, formation of ammonia. This is 2. So divide minus 92.4 over 2 to get minus 64, to get 46.2 kilo joule per mole. Okay, this is the same problem. This is the number of moles for sulfur. The N equal half, and this is delta H. You divide this number, this is delta H, over N, the number of moles for sulfur, half. In this way you can calculate delta H. No, thank you for listening.